Hi, welcome back. Today we're going to do a cardio abs workout. So it's a combination of cardio and abs exercises. You don't need any equipment at all, so get ready and let's start. Okay, starting this workout, we start with a short warming up, finish with a cooling down, and in between that, there's that main workout. Starting just with a warm up, step to the side from side to side, and just circle your arms. Small circles towards the front, shoulders are low, upper body straight, make sure your belly button is in, engage the abs, and just step from side to side, just to warm up the muscles, get the heart rate up a little. The main workout, cardio abs exercises only. We do 45 seconds active and then a 15 seconds active rest. Main workout is 10 different exercises. After the 10 exercises, you'll have a water break, reverse your circles. And after the water break, we will repeat the main exercises again. So you don't need any equipment. There are some floor exercises, but just on the hands or on the bed, so it's no problem at all. Keep circling your arms, small circles, warm up the shoulders. And lower your arms down. Okay, shoulder roll, come into a wide stand, going to do some windmill stretches. So make sure your knees are slightly bent, do not overstretch yet, not already warm enough. So bend over, and what we're going to do, we tap the feet and twist in the upper body. So we're going from left to right, from left to right. Swing your arms up like a windmill, tapping your toes. And remember, just to warm up the core a little. Getting loose, stiffness out of the body to go to that main workout. And like all of my workouts lately, there's no jumping involved, all low impact exercises. And of course, do every exercise on your own pace, always. But try to challenge yourself. Okay, just a few more swings. And we come up, slowly roll up, slightly bend the knees, and that's it. Okay, feet are closed, on hip wide. We're going to bend over doing a deadlift pulse. So what we're going to do is we trip the fingertips on the floor and come up. Only if you're able to reach over, otherwise go as far as you can. Bend over, come up. Bend over, little pulse, come up. If you can, touch the floor and come up. Just stretch up a little. Warm up. Tap, tap, up. Tap, tap, up. That's it. Up. And we go for the last one. Double tap and slowly come up. That's it. Okay, going over to the upper body circle. So feet are a little bit wider than the hips. Arms are going up in the air. You don't have to stretch out. Just circle your upper body. From left to the back to the right. To stretch up the obliques, the lower back, the abs. Because we're going to work that part of the body during this workout a lot. Circle around and around. Knees are slightly bent. And reverse your circles. Going to the right, to the back, to the left. Circle your upper body. Circle around and around. Lean back, feel that stretch. One more circle. And that's it. Lower your arms down. Going to do one more opener, and that's the hip rotation. So feet are on hip wide, knees are slightly bent, and just now rotate your lower body. Stretching up the hips a little. We're going to do some knee lifts. So make sure the hips are loose. From the left to the right, and reverse from the right towards the left side. So 10 exercises, 45 seconds on, 15 seconds active rest, and then you have a well-deserved water break in the middle of this workout. So one more circle. And that's it. Okay, shake out your legs. We're going over to that main workout. What we're going to do is a side step. We lean over a little and we cross reach to the knees. Just follow me along. So go down a little, tap and reach. So you twist in that upper body using the obliques. So tap and twist, tap and twist. It's important to keep your back straight and engage your abs. So squeeze it, pull your belly button in and twist in your upper body, working your obliques. Step from side to side and bring one leg towards your knees. Hop to the right, to the left, twist in your upper body. That's it. 10 seconds left. Tap, twist, that's it. Last one and come on up, great. The next exercise is a floor exercise. What we're going to do is a side to side plank. So come on your elbows. Elbows are under your shoulders. Come into the regular plank and then just twist over from side to the other side. Keep your hips up. Just rotate from side to side. Bring your elbow back on the floor and twist over to the other side. From side to side. And if you can't do that in a regular plank, of course, drop on your knees and twist from side to side. You can do that. Choose your option, but always challenge yourself. Twist in, and we keep that heart rate up by doing fast from side to side, and that's it. Coming up. And the next exercise is a high knee jack. So we push the arms up and down, lifting the knees up. Catch your breath a little, get ready, and go. So while you do these high knee jacks, your upper body is straight up, so we do not lean over. Just keep your upper body straight up. Lift the knees up, and pump the arms up and down. Under the knees, and all above your head. That's it. Come on, get the heart rate up. Pump the arms up and down, lift the knees up towards your chest. 10 seconds left. Up, 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 come on. Last one, that's it. Okay, recatch your breath a little. We're going to the floor again. What we're going to do is a seated cycling exercise. So we lean back, place the hands on the floor, fingertips pointing towards the butt. Going to lift the legs up and just cycle. You can place your elbows on the floor if you want. Choose your option, but cycle your legs. And of course, belly button is engaged. Feel your abs and just circle your legs like you're cycling your bike. Feel the burn in your abs. And by moving the legs, the heart rate is still up. So great cardio move. Come on, 10 seconds. Circle, circle, circle. Your legs around and around. And that's it. Okay, coming up for the next exercise. Next one is the cross jabs. What we're going to do is we twist in and make a jab. When we twist, make sure you engage your abs using your obliques to twist your upper body. So hands up and go. Jab, 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 jab. From side to side, power in those jabs. Lift the heel off the floor so you can twist your upper body. Bring the move from left to right. And of course, focus on the abs in this workout. So belly button is in, upper body is straight up, and squeeze it. Work your obliques. Twist in from side to side. 15 seconds left. Come on, power in those punches. The harder you punch, the more you have to squeeze your abs. Ha, twist, twist. And the last one, that's it. Okay, make your shoulder roll. The next one is a high plank, and we step from side to side. Just follow me along, so go down to the floor. High plank, so arms are stretched out, hands are under the shoulders, come into the high plank, and we walk from left, back to center, to the right side. So stretch out your legs, and walk from side to side. And of course, engage your abs, make sure your back is straight. From side to side, both feet center, both feet to the left, and both feet to the right. That's it. Come on your own pace. From side to side, work the core. From side, and one more on the left side, and come on out. Great effort. The next one is a high knee. And when we do the high knees, we push down the arms, so we make a little crunch movement for the abs. Okay, ready? And go. So push down with your arms, pull the knees up, and make that crunch. So squeeze the abs, and now you can bring your chest towards your knees a little. So you don't have to go straight up, just pump your chest and your knees towards each other. Push it, pump it. Come on, lift the knees up, chest down, 15 seconds. Keep going, push it down, crunch it. Last one, and that's it. Okay, re-catch your breath a little. Three more exercises, then you have that water break. The next one is a kind of a burpee walk, and we reach out. So we just go down, walk into the high plank, just follow me. So wide stand, place your hands on the floor, step out, back, come up, reach. Place your hands down on the floor, right under your shoulders. Step out into that high plank, back, and reach out. Up, reach out, that's it. Come on. Up and down, reach out, up. Few more, up, down. You're almost there, come on. We do one more. And reach out, and that's it. Okay, two more exercises. Next one is a standing cross crunch. So we lift the knee up, bring the elbow towards the knees, twist in the upper body. So okay, ready? And go. From side to side. And you bring your elbows towards your knees. You can twist in your upper body a little. Bring your chest a little bit towards your knees. Not too much, because you have to lift your knees up as well. From side to side, come on. Keep going, twist in your upper body, lift up your knees. 10 seconds left, come on. Twist in, use your abs. Last one on right and left, and that's it. Lower your arms down. One final exercise, then you have the water break. The next one we're going to do is a side step, and we bend to the side with our upper body. Great exercise for the core. So hands in your waist, step and bend. From side to side, big step, bend that upper body, come back center, and work your obliques. Come on, squeeze it, bend and up, bend. Yes, from side to side, come on. Upper body side bends while stepping from side to side. So keep your hips still, just bending your upper body. That's it, 10 seconds. Almost there, keep on making those side bends, working the obliques. Last one on left, final on right, and that's it. Very well done, you finished the first round. Now have some water break, take some water, and make sure you're ready for the second round. Same exercise so you can follow along. See you in the next round. Okay, get ready for that second round. We do the same 10 exercise we did in the first round. So 45 seconds on, 15 seconds active rest, combination of standing and floor exercises. We start with a step crossover reaches. So lean over and tap it from side to side. And with this exercise, it's important to twist in your upper body to work your obliques. So make sure your belly button is in, you squeeze your abs, tighten your core, and just twist and tap. And swing your arms. And the faster you go, the more the heart rate is up, of course. But focus on twisting that upper body. Focus on the abs during this workout. Come on, twist in. Just a few more. Last one on the right. And that's it, come on up. Okay, we go to the floor for the side-to-side plank. Low planks, we twist in from side to side on your knees if you have to, but try to focus on the core, elbows under your shoulders, into the regular plank, and twist. From side to side, keep your hips up. From side to side, place your elbows back under your shoulder, keep your back straight. And it's a great one for the core. And of course, your abs belong to your core power. So the faster you twist, the more your heart rate is getting up. Come on. Twist in. 15 seconds left. Up. Twist. Up. To the left. On the right. And final one on left. Hold it. And that's it, okay, coming up. Next one is the high knee jacks. So re-catch your breath just a little. Stay active. Get ready. Arms up and go. So lift the knees up. Pump your arms up and down. And with the high knee jacks, the upper body is straight up. So your back is straight. Belly button is in. And lift your knees up, working the lower abs by lifting the knees and getting the heart rate up by pumping your arms up and down. Up, up, that's it. Come on, lift the knees up. 15 seconds. Up, up, up. Almost there. Lift up. And that's it, great. Okay, go to the floor, re-catch your breath. Going over for the seated cycling exercise. So elbows or hands on the floor, choose your option. Engage your abs, belly button in, and just cycle. So you're on your bike, cycling, not thinking about the abs, the burn, just cycle. Around. Come on, circle your legs. Feel the burn in your abs. Rotate your legs. Come on. Keep going. Circling, circling. 10 seconds. Come on. Feel the burn in your abs. And that's it. Okay, release and come on up for the next exercise. And that's that cross jab. So we lift the heel, turn the toe, twist in the upper body, working the obliques. So get ready, hands up, and go. Twist, twist, twist. And power in those punches. You have to squeeze your abs. Twist in, twist, twist. Come on. Belly button is in, back is straight, and power in those punches. From left to right, knees are slightly bent. Just lift your heel up so you can twist. Twist in. Come on, 15 seconds. Power in those punches, come on. Work your abs, twist it. Almost there. Right, left, right, left, and that's it. Lower your arms down. Okay. The next one is that high plank and the side-to-side walk. So both feet are going to the right, then back center, over to the left side. So come on, hands under your shoulders, and walk to the right. Back center, walk to the left. So we're going from side to side, hands are under the shoulders, the belly button is in, we engage the abs, and it's another one. Great for the core, and by stepping from left to right, the heart rate keeps up. 15 seconds left, come on. Walk back from right over to left. Almost there, we finish on the left side, and come up. Wow, you're doing so great. The next one is that high knee, and we push down, so the chest is going towards the knees, knees are going up, make little crunches. excuse me, come on and go. So, push the chest down, and the knees up. And every time you do that, squeeze your abs. Come on. Power in the push downs. Lift the knees up. Come on, get your heart rate up. 20 seconds. Up, up, up. Come on. Squeeze your abs, crunch it. 10 seconds. Almost there. Come on, and that's it. Okay, very well done. Three more exercises. Going over to the burpee plank, reach out. So no jumping, just stepping out into that high plank, and then come back up, reach out. So come into that wide stand, and go. Hands to the floor, into that high plank, reach out. And reach, down. Reach. Come on, it's a very intense cardio abs workout. You can do this, always get the best of you. Challenge yourself, even if you're not in the mood, you always feel better after a good workout. Let me know if that isn't true. Come on, up. Reach out, almost there. Final one, reach and stay up. Okay, next one, standing cross crunch. So elbows going to the opposite knee, twist in the upper body. Come on, get ready, hands up and go. So you can make a little crunch, bringing the chest over, twist in your upper body and lift your knees up. All at the same time. And make sure you speed up the pace a little. Make sure that heart rate is up. Come on, you're almost there. 15 seconds left of this exercise. Come on, twist in. Bring the knees up, elbows towards the knees. You can do this. Up, last one. That's it, lower your arms down. Final exercise, then go to the cooling down. Final one, side step, side bend. And make sure your hips are still, so do not push out your hips to the side. Only upper body bends for those obliques. Okay, ready? Go. Step and bend. Bring your upper body from side to side. Shoulder is going down low, and you can feel that in your obliques. So squeeze it. Belly button is still in, upper body straight. Just step to the side, keep your hips still, and drop your shoulder to the right side and the left side. Come on, final seconds of this workout, and then over to that cooling down. 5 seconds left, stepped out, final on left, and we finish on right, and that's it. Very well done. Recatch your breath. It's over for the cooling down, so time to recover a little bit from this workout. So first, we're going to reduce the pace. We twist in our upper body from side to side, but at a slow pace, very slow. So you can take deep breath in, deep breath out, recover, recatch your breath, and just release the tension out of your abs. So no more squeezing, just relax, twist in, and if you want, you can swing your arms a little by going from side to side. Twist, twist, bring your shoulders from side to side. Deep breath in, and out, and that's a good recovery from this cardio and abs workout. And I would love to see the comments below this video. Let me know how you did it, what you think of this workout, if you want to see more of these exercises in upcoming workouts, of course. Okay, enough for the twist. We're going over for the upper body stretch. So one hand in your hip, on your hip, and then bend over. Feel that stretch in your obliques, in your waistline. And twist in a little bit, open your chest. So lean back a little, you can feel the stretch in your frontal abs a little bit more. And over to the other side. Hand in your hip, reach over. First stretching up the side. Oh, low ceiling. And then twist open for another angle of the stretch. And release. Okay. Feet on hip wide, knees are slightly bent, shoulders are low, and we're going to rotate our head from left over to the back to the right. Chin on the chest. Big circles. And reverse. Rotate your neck from side to side. And that's it. Now stretch up your neck so shoulder is down low and you pull your head towards the other side. So make sure your ear is touching your left shoulder and feel that stretch in your neck. Over to the other side. Do not pull too hard. Just a slightly stretch in your neck muscles. Your neck has to carry your head around all day, so make sure to stretch it now and then. Okay, that's it. Now over to the wrist stretch. We did a lot of high plank exercises, so a lot of effort on the tendons, the wrist. So stretching up, make sure you strangle your fingers, make some rotations. And now hand palms open up and feel that stretch. And release. Now take your hand and pull your fingers towards your shoulders. You can feel that stretch in your wrist. Now flip over to the other side and pull your hand down, your wrist over your hand. and pull your fingers towards your hips so you can feel the stretch on the upper side of your lower arm. Okay, over to the other wrist. Fingers down, hand palms open. Feel that stretch. Of course, you can do it upwards, but make sure the stretch is on the downside of the arm. And now open to the other side. Feel the stretch in the upper part of your lower arm and your wrists. Okay, one more rotation. And shake out your hands. Okay, one more stretch and then we're finished. Come into that wide stand. Make sure you keep that forward fold. So stretch out your legs. Place your hands on the floor if you can. Otherwise, reach over as far as you can. Now one hand is going up. Open up. Reach over. Place your hand back on the floor. Over to the other side. Watch your hand. Twist your upper body open as far as you can. Place your hand back with the other one hand. Slightly bend your knees. Roll up. And that's it. Okay, very well done. You finished this cardio abs workout. Make sure if you like it, you subscribe to the channel. Invite your friends to follow along. Let's grow the community of these home workouts. And I hope to see you in the next workout. Another time, another day. Have a great day.